baptism earlier today. In the 16th century, there was a man by the name of John Calvin. He was what you would call a Reformed theologian. He went against much of the Catholic tradition. During that time, there was a tradition out with Catholicism that believed that when you came to baptism saved, and that you had to be baptized as an infant. Now, as Baptists, we don't believe that, because we believe that as believers, you must believe in order to be baptized. That's our belief system, you know. And so that's why we don't baptize infants. That's just not our tradition. We don't go against those who do, but that's just not our tradition. We believe the scripture says that he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. But then he believed that communion, when you took communion, you were literally eating the body and blood and drinking the blood of Jesus. So when the priest would hold the bread up, it would no longer be bread, but it would be Jesus' body. Or when he held up the cup and said, "This is my blood," this we would be drinking Jesus' blood. But I've said before, that would make us religious cannibalists. But what John Calvin held to was this, is that when we come to the table, no, we're not eating the body, and no, we're not drinking the blood, but it's symbolism. And church, I keep reminding you of the importance of being around the Lord's table. And it's not just about coming to the table, but it's also about having your heart right, your motivation right. And always make sure that when you come to Jesus, come to this table, you keep your heart and your mind on Jesus. So that when you come to the table, don't bring all your issues. Lay aside your issues. Lay aside your every weight and the sin that goes so easily beset you. Now, I'm not just talking about on communion Sunday. Every day you ought to get strapped and lay something aside. I mean, but particularly when you come to the table, you ought to come with your mind on Jesus. Yeah. But every day you wake up, you ought to be saying, "Lord, fix me." Yeah. That's why I've always said to y'all, that's why we don't have time to worry about nobody else. Because we got so much around our own yard that we don't have time to be throwing stones at nobody else. Amen. Am I right, church here? We don't have time to be gossiping about nobody, talking about nobody. Because the reality is, you pointing fingers, and you got about 12 fingers pointing at you. Am I right, church? Be mindful, church. And when we come to the table, it's about fellowship. And we can't have fellowship if we're being bitter, nasty, and mean to one another. We can't be divided. Father, in Jesus' name, thank you for the opportunity to come to your table. Table that represents your broken body and your shed blood. Now, dear God, bless as much of this bread and this cup. Bless our heart. Forgive us of things that we've said, done, things that we failed to do. Continue to strengthen us for this journey. And we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Mountain. Mountain. And it flows. Let me hear you, church. Today, we will live. Drinking of the wine, drinking of